Okay, so the next one is called Christians. This is kind of referring to William Lane Craig. He's a famous Christian debater, and I'll read something to you. It's part one and part two. I'll read part one and see if you have any comments, and we'll go to part two. Okay.
Okay, great.
So basically, the idea is that they say that they can feel the personal relationship with God, and that's how they know God exists. And this is not something that they would debate because they can't really show somebody else, but they just know themselves that God exists. So here's Dr. Craig talking. He says, "All right, first of all, it is very important to understand that the witness of the Holy Spirit is not just a subjective religious experience. This is an objective reality. It's a witness which God Himself bears with our spirit. It is as objective as light rays impinging upon your retina and causing you to see something. This is an objective work and activity of God on the spirit. So this isn't just some sort of subjective religious experience that arises from your own emotions and feelings. Having said that, that does not mean that the witness of the Holy Spirit serves as objective evidence for the Christian faith as the reader seems to think. That is misunderstanding of what one is talking about here. The witness of the Holy Spirit is not construed as evidence from which you can then infer that God exists, as though one infers from this experience that the best explanation of this experience is that there really is a God. There are arguments like that from religious experience, but this is not an argument from a religious experience. In fact, it is not an argument at all. It is a claim that you can know that God exists and that Christianity is true wholly apart from arguments, simply through the inner testimony of God to your heart. So don't think of this as an argument from religious experience. Rather, it is the claim that for the person to whom God bears witness by means of this spiritual testimony, such a person can know with confidence that Christianity is true because of the witness that God bears to him." So let me repeat this last line. It is the claim that for the person to whom God bears witness by means of the spiritual testimony, such a person can know with confidence that Christianity is true because of the witness that God bears to him. So, what do you think about that?
Bernie, have you ever seen a dog chase its own tail?
Yep.
That's exactly what that sounded like to me. I would say this. I have a psychology degree, which of course doesn't make me a psychologist. Just means I know about some things about the mind, and I had to go through classes for 4 years to learn about them. I know the mind is very powerful, and emotions are incredibly strong. And I also know at the same time, people will believe what they want to believe. And so I know people who, and I have been one, I've been there, people who believe they feel God. They feel His presence. They feel His moving in their life. They can feel the Holy Spirit in their midst. I've been there and done that. But I also know that when you deal with the mind and you deal with emotions, that to tell me that I can believe in God because I can feel Him, which is just my paraphrase of what he said, is incredibly inaccurate, and I think it's almost dangerous because it takes you to a place where you are placing your life and afterlife, you would, if you believe in that, on the existence of something because you feel it, and feelings, they're different for everybody. You know, and to take it straight to a, I realize this is not close to what we're dealing with the presence of a divine creator. But if two people are in the same room, you ever notice how one person is says it's hot and the other says it's cold? It's because that's what they feel. And when you're in church, you're around people, you're singing a song or praying a prayer or hearing a message, your mind is into it. Your emotions are into it, and you're going to feel what is being referred to. So I can't go to that level to say I believe in God because I feel Him. I mean, I've been in church and got goosebumps and said, "Oh, God's here, I feel goosebumps." In reality, I was probably just getting the flu or getting sick.
Have you
You
ever
know, chills.
had like a pastor lay hands on you and you have a fall down or anything like that?
I've had him push me really hard. I've
Okay.
had that. So want me to do what we call a courtesy drop. Yeah.
Did you ever speak in tongues or anything like that? You spoke in tongues.
I did, but I think
And you
when
said that was the Holy Spirit.
I at the time, absolutely.
And you really believed it.
I did absolutely at the time. I don't now. I don't.
Yeah,
I've
I mean, I'm with you there too. Like whenever a Christian says, "I feel led by the Holy Spirit and God showed me this and all that," I understand 100%. I believe I was there also. So one thing that people say to me when I tell them that, some Christians say to me, they'll say like, "I don't understand if it's like how you." They don't understand because they're saying, "How could you feel it if you don't if God doesn't exist?" I guess what they don't understand is a delusion. They think, I guess they're stuck that if you feel it, it's got to be true.
Right. And again, that's your feelings can mislead you. Now I can't argue feelings because I can't tell you whether what you feel is right or wrong. But that's another thing that makes it so dangerous is, people of all times will feel that they're right about something, and maybe they're arguing or they're debating, and they're wrong. But they feel it. I feel I'm right. Well, in this case, it's the same. I feel God. Well, what are you feeling? Well, I just feel something different. I feel maybe I got chills. Maybe I just feel more aware. Whatever it is, it's a feeling, but you're basing everything on a feeling, and that's so dangerous. So dangerous.
Yeah, this reminds me too when I was a Christian that there's sometimes, there's chain letters that go through email and they have stories that are inspirational. So there's one where this professor is giving a lecture on the Bible, and of course he's not a believer. And somebody, he says, "Is there any questions in the audience?" And some old man in the back of the room raises his hand and he goes, "Yes, what's your question?" And the guy goes, "Well, professor," and he chomp chomp on his apple. "I heard what you had to say, chomp, 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 and I just have one question, chomp, chomp, chomp." He goes, "Tell me, was this apple I tasted, chomp, chomp, was it sweet or sour?" And the professor goes, "I have no idea. I don't know what you tasted there. I can't taste that apple." And he goes, "Neither, sir, can you taste my Jesus?" So basically, he's saying, he's got this feeling for Jesus, and you can't put that down because that's his feeling. It's beyond. What I think is really powerful is when there are people who were Christians and are now atheists, like you and me. We both say, "Hey, we know those feelings. We felt it. We can taste your Jesus. We tasted it. We've been there, and it must be a delusion because we are. I'm convinced there is no God. The Bible God. I'm convinced. I'm convinced there's no Bible God. So it's got to be a God delusion. That's the only explanation.
Right. I agree.
I went to a lot of people getting hands laid on me. I wanted to speak in tongues. I never spoke in tongues, but I did went forward a lot of times to have people place their hands on me, and I never really felt anything. But I did finally feel some kind of electric shock from one thing, and it really perplexed me. And I just think it's really the power of there's something psychological going on there. And just to show Christians that it's not just them, the evangelical Christians, I actually felt that presence one time about the Book of Mormon. They said, "Pray about the Book of Mormon and then see if you get a burning in the bosom." And I prayed and I got that burning, but I knew I couldn't become a Mormon because I knew it's nonsense. So there is a powerful delusion there that the mind can manufacture. It's a pretty interesting thing.
Well, I mean, sure. And when you think about things, going way back, I remember as a child watching Sesame Street, and then one of the Muppets on there had a lemon, and it told every kid watching to take that imaginary lemon in your hand and put it up to your mouth and taste it, and you could taste the lemon. As a little kid, I wanted to be a part of that world, and I could taste that lemon, but I wasn't holding the lemon. In the same way, you have people going, "I want to feel that God," and they want to feel it so bad, and they want to be a part of that group and get that, what they would call the anointing of God, so much that they're going to feel it no matter what, because the mind is so powerful and the emotions are so strong.
Yeah, I'd recommend for people who want to know more about that, go on YouTube and look at Darren Brown, Derren. He's a mentalist in the UK, and there's one video called Darren Brown, the So-Called Messiah, and he's actually got some videos. He's an atheist, and he actually converted another atheist to Christianity, just showing the tricks that you can use to do something like that. It's pretty incredible.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll move on to the next one. You have any closing words on that topic?
On that one, no, I think that's a dangerous one. And when you say feel, you know, I believe what I feel, that can be trouble sometimes.
Okay, so this last one is a question, and this comes up in Christian atheist debates.